Good morning, church. Good morning. It is time for us to begin this hour of worship. I invite you to stand to your feet. We're going to sing a song this morning that is familiar, written by Charles Wesley shortly after he was saved. What we don't realize about this hymn is it has many, many more stanzas to it than we actually ever sing. The hymn has a total of 66 stanzas. We're not going to sing all of them. Don't worry. But we are going to sing the first one that we know, and this is what it says. Oh, for a thousand tongues to sing my great Redeemer's praise, the glories of my God and King, the triumphs of His grace. If eloquence I could display and every language sing, a thousand words could never say the praise I have for Thee. Before the throne we'll sing the song with saints from every age, with thousands times 10,000 strong, we'll praise His holy name. A thousand years will be as one when face to face I see the splendid beauty of the Son, the one who died for me. So I want us to sing this together this morning as we testify, as we recall what it was to be a new believer in Christ. Oh, I had a thousand tongues to sing the one who has saved me. Church, let's sing this together. Sing it out.
For a thousand tongues to sing my great Redeemer's praise, the glories of my God and King, the triumphs of His grace.
If eloquence I could display,
if eloquence I could display, and every language speak, a thousand words could never say the praise I have for
Thee. Hallelujah. The third stanza, before the throne.
Before the throne we'll sing a song with saints from every age, with thousands times 10,000 strong, we'll praise His holy.
Yeah.
So, Lord, we come before you this morning as your children, those bought with so great a price. Lord, we join with the heavenlies. Sometimes, Lord, we feel so small, so insignificant. But, Lord, you have saved each one of us by your grace, by the blood of the Lamb. And, Lord, we join with thousands upon thousands upon ten thousands. Our Lord is faithful. He gives us his mercies fresh and new each morning. He is the one who's kept every promise that he has made, and he is the one we praise this morning. Let's sing praise to him. He is promise maker.
Promise maker, promise keeper, you finish what you began. Our provision through the desert, you see it through till the end. You see it through till the end. Lord, our God is ever faithful, never changing. Darkness, you will lead us.
Take away my sin. serve a great God, don't we, church? You know, God is doing some great, great, great works at this place. You know, yesterday was a huge day for us. Maybe many of you spent some time up here. The Baptist men had their great chicken slaying, as we call it, around here. You know, we laugh about it, and it's fun, but they there was a lot of people who volunteered, who put in a lot of hard work, and I talked with Bill Brown this morning. He said that we raised over $5,000 to go to missions. And in just a few weeks, basically end of October, beginning of November, we have a trip going to Honduras, continuing our partnership there. And the money that was raised yesterday goes towards that partnership. In fact, the mission that you did, dinner that you did back in the spring is fully funding this trip that's coming up. So God is good. God is at work. We actually even got, I forgot to mention this in the first service, but the town of Wendell yesterday, they had been raising money. It was 12 kids had been raising money towards local food banks. We're getting a check for $2,500 for our food bank here. You know, and it's a great season for that to come, because here's why. You know, Feast of Plenty is coming up in a few weeks. You know, amidst all the other things that Kevin mentioned, but hey, that's one of our largest events that we have. It's November 15th this year. We're going to talk about that. You're going to get some information in your bulletin next week. But God is working here. You know, this church is out, and it's in the community, and we are seeing people saved. We're seeing God work. There's another key date for you to mark on your calendar, October 19th. October 19th, you probably saw it in your bulletin, but we are having our regularly scheduled business meeting, but after that, a special call business meeting to move forward with our building. And so we're going to have more information for you next week, but we're asking everyone, this is a key, crucial point in our church for the next few decades. And so we're asking everyone to be able to be here, to be able to attend for that. But ushers, why don't you come forward this morning? You know, this is the start. If you don't know, it's the start for a new year for us as a church. Our budget year runs October through September, so why don't we get a good start? You know, God is doing so much, whether it's here, whether it's locally with activities like Feast of Plenty, whether it's other local outreaches and things that we do, or whether it's to our partnerships like Honduras, Moldova, Canada. You know, we can't do that without your faithfulness to give, and without your faithfulness to go. So let's worship the Lord this morning through our tithes and our offerings. Pray for us, please.
Let us pray. Lord God Almighty, I come this morning humbled. Lord, I praise you, not only for this church, Lord, but your people that's in it. Lord, as we sang this morning, how great thou art, Lord, chills just run through my body. Lord, we have no idea how great you really are. Lord, I praise you this morning for all that you do in my life, my family's life, and all those that are present here. The great I am, the healer, the provider, Lord, the King of kings and Lord of lords. Lord, as we lift Addie up this morning, Lord, and the other ones with other physical needs, Lord, and spiritual needs and financial needs, Lord, I just ask them, let us lay them at the foot of the cross this morning. Lord, may you honor us in a way and present yourself to us in a way that we feel you each and every moment. Lord, as we go our different ways this week, we have an opportunity, and that opportunity is to share your word. Lord, how can we go each day and not share your word with what you do in our lives? Lord, again, I just praise you beyond what I can apprehend, how great you are. Lord, as we give a small part back this morning, Lord, it's just a small part of what you give us. Help us to be good stewards of your money. Help us to be vessels. Help us to give like you ask us to, Lord. Lord, for us in Jesus' name I pray.
As we are worshiping through giving this morning, I've asked Jill and Sarah Talley to bless us and to minister. They're always so faithful when I call, and you will be blessed as you listen to them play.